In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up Audiomodern Playbeat 4 as a standalone MIDI and also as a MIDI generator so we can generate other sampled instruments within Kontakt or whatever your choice is using the patterns and the AI technology that Playbeat 4 offers. I'm going to show you how to set up Playbeat 4 as a MIDI generator in Ableton. First up, what we want to do is we want to insert a MIDI track. And on the MIDI track, we want to load up Playbeat 4. So if we just search for it in here, Playbeat 4. We load that in. Let's just make sure we get some sound. And we do. Next up, what we want to do is we want to insert another MIDI track because this is what's going to be feeding from Playbeat 4, and this is where we're going to choose what software instrument we want or what drum rack we want. So what we want to do is we then want to pull in a drum rack of our choice. Let's just go with the 505, bring that in. So now we have Playbeat 4 and we've got a drum rack loaded up. What we want to do is we want to send out of the MIDI from the Playbeat 4, you know, going into our other software track, which is the other MIDI one, which is the drum rack, so that we can get the drum patterns from Playbeat 4 playing into the choice of our sound, which is the 505 core kit. So to do that, what we want to do is set this up to Playbeat 4, Playbeat 4. Now what you'll see is when I play it, you'll see nothing will come out. Or some things are coming out, but not everything. And the reason for that is because you can see here how we've got the letters, C sharp one is rim shot, we've got snares, D ones, you know, and so forth. You can see, so we need to set that up in Playbeat 4. So to do this, what we need to do is we need to go to the settings, and then we need to go here, and it's really important that we turn these on, because what it means is you can see here, we've got track 1 to 8. That means we can have up to 8 triggers within this plugin that can give us up to 8, you know, elements, percussive elements, whether that's kick, snare, hand claps, it can give us up to 8 in their patterns. And then what we want to do is if we look here, you can see if we go bass drum, which is kick, you can see it's on C1, but at the moment it's on C3. So we need to program this to trigger the right drum element or the right drum sound. So if we go C1 and then let's say we want a snare, that's D1, and then we've won, let's say, a closed hat, that's F sharp one. After the closed hat, let's go with a tom, let's go with a tom one, a high tom, let's go B1. So we're gonna go B1, and then let's go middle tom, A1, and a low tom, G sharp one, and then let's go with, let's do a hand clap, so that's D sharp one, and then we'll finish it off with a crash, which is C sharp two. Now, the next thing that's super important is you want to make sure that you lock the MIDI outputs, because when I then change presets, these are going to stay the same. You know, what you don't want to do is you don't want to set all of this up and then you change presets and then it changes all of the triggers notes, because then it's just going to have, you're going to have to redo it. So it's super important that you lock the MIDI outputs, and then that way it stays consistent across all the patterns that you use, and then you can just go and play around with the patterns. Now, what we want to do is if we solo our drum kit, so we're not getting any of the original Playbeat 4 sounds, and then go back to Playbeat 4, and then now you'll hear that we're just hearing the drum rack being triggered by the pattern in Playbeat. It's just amazing, because you know, we can get creative with different patterns, and what's really cool is we can use Playbeat 4 as like the AI to get the drum patterns that we want. If you go here, you've got the AI section, but then we can, you know, use the sounds that we want of our choice in Ableton with different drum racks, so we can get really creative with it. So as you can see here, I've got Logic Pro X loaded up in the default mode. Now what we're going to do is we're going to use Audiomodern Playbeat 4 as a MIDI generator to trigger different AI patterns that this plugin offers us and use it with another software instrument. So for example, Kontakt. So let's try that. So first up, what we're going to do is you want to get the routing correct. So we want to create a MIDI software instrument again, but instead of having it as an instrument, we want to create it as a MIDI effects in Logic. So we're going to go no plugin, turn off bus 3 and 4, go to the MIDI effects, Audio Modern Playbeat 4. Now this is going to be our, you know, trigger. So we're going to use patterns from this AI module. So Then what we're going to do is we're going to load up an instrument track in the instrument section. Let's load up contact. So you can see here we've got Native Instruments contact loaded up, and we're using the Abbey Road 60s early drum kit. And what we're going to do is we're going to trigger this drum kit from the AI designed drum design pattern from Playbeat 4, and we're going to trigger it using the sounds from Abbey Road drum kit, which is just crazy. So the way that we want to do this is we want to get the MIDI kind of rooted and set up right within Playbeat 4. So to do this, what we want to do is load up Playbeat 4, go to the settings, go to this module here, and you'll see that we've got from track 1 to 8. So we can trigger up to 8 MIDI triggers to whatever sample instrument that we want to use. And so in this case, you can see it's set to C3, C#3. Now what we want to do is we want to go back to contacts and see what our triggers are. And I believe kick is at C1, as you can see up here. So what you want to do is you want to go back here and you want to go C1 to change it from C3 to C1. And this just allows it so that it knows that C1 is going to trigger the kick in this plugin. So you have to set this up. It takes a little bit of time, and then we can go hit the snare. That is D1. So we change track 2 to D1. Hat is F#. You can see here, I'm just going through them. And what you want to make sure is you want to make sure these are on, so they're not off, they're on. So it just makes sure that it is actually being triggered. And then, you know, you do this and so forth. So you just pick what you want, you know, out of the drum kit and what you want to trigger from the patterns. And then it's really important that you lock the MIDI output. Now, the reason for that is because if you then change preset, at the moment, I've just got it in the default mode. But if I go up here and I want to change it to a different preset, if I go back to settings, I want these to stay there. I don't want them to change. So it just means that whatever, you know, preset I'm using or the patterns that I'm using, it's still recognizing the same triggers that's going to the Abbey Road drummer in this case. So, you know, if we just play it, you can see that I'm using Playbeat 4 as an AI pattern and triggering the Abbey Road drummer in contact as, you know, how I want the drums to be. And, you know, if you wanted, let's say, the tambourine to be on, you know, a different kind of one on here, you can change it on here, and then you can go back to the settings and go to your, you know, you like say you got up to 8, you go to track 8 and you could change that to whatever the tambourine is on and so forth. So it's super clever that we can do that with all within one plugin. And that is how that I set up in Logic Pro the MIDI trigger via MIDI effects, and that way I can control software instruments that is not from Playbeat 4, but using the AI from Playbeat 4 into different drum sample packs, which is super cool.